absolutely Alphas.
Absolutely
Tones.
And Trina.
We out here.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Make sure you hit that subscribe button right away.
If and, you haven't already.
And the notification bell, that helps out a lot.
Yes.
And we will continue to deliver and, you know, and
the purest
get better, you know what I mean? Get better and better for y'all. Deliver every time for y'all, you know?
Yes. Absolutely Alphas at Gmail. Mm-hmm. Support our Patreon. Absolutely Alphas. Twitter is Absolute Alphas. Facebook, Alphas Explained. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you for sticking with us this long.
Thank you.
And we got a new review. Happy Halloween if you're celebrating. I'm a little Kim out here. I'm going to throw shade if I can't get paid. See you, girl. All right.
Yeah, well, while we playing this new school singing shit is going on, this trap singing shit is going on. So we're going to cram a few, but you know what I mean? We're going to skim through them, though. So we got, first of all, we got Canibus Full Spectrum Dominance 2, which, you know, we know most of our fans, most of our, you know, views that we've gotten on this channel have come from I'll say FSD 1 from now on.
FSD, yes.
So, you know, I'm disappointed that I wasn't able to see the new release, you know, when it came out initially, because I've been checking Spotify every Friday.
Yeah, we both do, and I definitely would have saw that.
Yeah, so, you know.
So, Spotify, what's up with that?
Boo to them, you know, because, I mean, they got all kinds of other, like, especially for me, like, they have, like, a bunch of new releases that have nothing to do with, like, the shit I listen to.
Right.
And it should be better at, like, knowing what the fuck I'm going to hear, so.
Ooh.
I'm a little upset. So we got, you know, FSD 2, Canibus.
Yeah.
We got
Black
Eyed Peas, Masters of the Sun Volume 1. Then we got Tory Lanez, and this is called Love Me Now.
He's a singer.
I think he's in the hip hop category though. Like it's like I googled it. He's, you know what I mean, because that's how all rappers
said singer.
That's how all rappers sound. All rappers sound like that, though. Like, I mean, the new rappers that came out since 2016, they be trap singing.
I should have said hip-hop artist, though.
It says hip-hop artist on his profile. That's what it says.
Oh, but not on Wikipedia.
It's on Google. I mean, I don't know what page that derived from. I was just on Google.
Why didn't you ask me how my week was, though?
What? I did ask you that.
You didn't.
I didn't.
We ain't talking about that.
How was your week?
I'm fitting. I took out my glasses on so y'all can't see my tears out here. But, it was all right. It was good. Another good week. Got cold. It was cold a few days.
Yeah, it got a little chilly out there.
Went to a Halloween party last night. Had a whole nother wig. I was the 70s out here. You ever see the Cosby episode where Denise tried to sew Theo a Gordon Gartrell shirt and he ended up messed up? It's like a yellow shirt.
I didn't see that one.
So he remade the shirt, basically. He was in here, like, sewing it, and it looked just like, it was so funny. Okay. I'll probably put a picture of it up. But yeah, my week was lit. Had our first event, Impress Her, Ladies of Impress Her, another initiative I'm doing with a group of wonderful women. And we had a paint night on Thursday.
Yeah,
it was our first event with the Sip and Paint in Hampton. Dope. Black Panther. I should have a Black Panther. Oh, I'll put the picture up right here.
Okay. Over me. Yeah.
Right.
Over my likeness. Right, where her hand was.
How was you, brother?
It was lit. You can go on the Alpha Explain page and see the little intro to the party I was at. Shouts to Chris Clayton out here, one of my trusted MMA teachers. And then, you know, check out Grammy Sheep for a little bit. Norfolk is like, the whole city of Norfolk is lit right now on Halloween weekend. It's not even Halloween yet.
More than summertime.
But it's just kids and like the hoods. And more than, this is like a more lit day than any day I saw in summer. Wow. And like, you know, just kids and like just ghetto people everywhere. It's just, it's lit. It's
how you know that there was all ghetto though?
It's Norfolk, y'all. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's a lot of money in Norfolk, too.
Yeah, in downtown. You know, if you ain't Ghent.
That's where you was at, ain't it?
No, I mean, not downtown, like Park Place and Tower to Park and shit. Not that downtown.
Oh, okay.
You know, so I'm talking about Ghent. Like, yeah, I mean, Grammy Street kind of runs into Ghent. And we ain't getting into that. So, okay, so we got FSD 2, Love Me Now, Wrld On Drugs, and then Masters of the Sun Volume 1. In any particular order that we want to go in.
Wrld On Drugs, we already did a little review on that.
We did, yeah. I was, you know what? And I still don't really have to say a whole lot about it. I'll just say that.
Like a lot.
Yeah, but I can actually cram three of the reviews in one, or two of them anyway, because I would say the same thing about Love Me Now and Wrld On Drugs, and I would give Love Me Now 1 point higher. So Wrld On Drugs would get a 4, and Love Me Now would get a 5.
Okay.
So basically, beats be on like this. These two albums, Quavo's album, Quavo Huncho, like the beats would be good on their own, but very, very few beats are like so great and excellent that they can overcome the garbage that's being spit. So that means some, the beats aren't like great, you know. There are a few great beats on each album, but you know, most times, like, you know, if the instrumentals just would have played well on their own. Like, you know, they could have made great instrumental albums and had a 10 probably.
You talking about Love Me Now
again? I'm talking about Love Me Now and Wrld On Drugs collectively, because the same thing applies
to both. You don't even want to talk about those two on this show.
Yeah, but that's, I'm not doing the track by track. So
I feel like maybe we're going to talk about
it. Yeah, so I mean, but I did say that we were going to do Wrld On Drugs and do like a little technical analysis. So, I mean, that's really all I had to say. What you about to do?
Canibus Full Spectrum Dominance. That's what I listen to. FSD2. So again, this is Canibus, so very particular set of fans that we got a lot of feedback from, and thank you guys for listening.
Yeah, we're a little late though because of Spotify.
A little late because of Spotify, which I found that very interesting. So this is Backpack Hip Hop. That's what he is considered. Album's 8 tracks, 2 tracks are interludes, 24 minutes. It was released September 7th. So yeah, we're a little behind. The artwork is similar. The font was different. Bolder font. I like the font. I like the font on the second one.
Yeah.
Produced by Nappy Music, Thanos Beats, and a few others. It's a decent album. The intro is this... Try not to do that. The intro was this terrifying voice. Like,
yeah, it was. Pretty scary.
It was like an alien is supposed to be being interviewed by somebody, I guess, from NASA or the government. And they're like, well, what are you coming here for? And he's basically warning us. And it sounds like terrifying. Like, it sounded scary. It scared me. Like, yeah. I probably wouldn't listen to it at night.
Here it is for y'all. Just so you can hear it in the background and how terrifying and scary it is. You know what I mean? So you can feel the feeling in your heart as well.
Mm. So then on Genius, because, you know, I look up the lyrics and stuff and it gets the details for the album.
Uh-huh.
But,
shit is real.
Yeah. So, what was I gonna say? I was just about to say something. First track, there's 8 tracks. 2 are interludes, and, so there's 6 tracks. And there's a really long one that's about 7 minutes, Kambada. My all hands down favorite track, Kambada, featuring Kambada.
Mm-hmm.
He's basically saying the message is clear that we are the gods as black people. Like, we're the gods of the universe. We were here first, and we're advanced. That's kind of what he's getting at with that track. There's a beat switch near the end of it that is phenomenal. Combative versus fire. Like, it's one of the best.
You said Kambada's here?
Canibus
always has perfect. Canibus always has great features.
Yeah.
Like, he's never had a whack feature in his album.
Yeah.
Ever.
So, Nationwide Ruckus. I thought it was interesting, like I was saying about Genius, that the lyrics weren't on Genius. For 2 different tracks.
Well,
which is, I've never seen that before in any album that I've looked up.
I see that.
They had,
I see that pretty frequently when we're like right on like the review, like we're starting to record like 2 days after the album came out,
yeah.
And we're still new. I've seen that happen pretty frequently, but I mean, for this to be almost 2 months later,
right?
It's a little weird, yeah.
And it's different if the album, the whole album out there, but to have some tracks there and then 2 not, you know what I mean? I've never seen that, so. I just think everything is a conspiracy, also. Maybe that's what's happening. But yeah, can you turn it on?
Oh.
I always feel like it's blasting and I'm trying to yell over it.
It's probably moving out on set too. Sorry about that, y'all.
Sounds like Busta Rhymes on the fourth. Is that Busta Rhymes?
On this?
Or on the first, or on the Nationwide Records?
I thought. That's not Busta Rhymes. I thought it was like a something from a Wu-Tang sample.
Say Arsenio.
somebody like I know I've heard it before, but I mean we could probably Google Nationwide Ruckus lyrics and like it'll pull up. But
okay, so the next
somebody comment what it is.
Yeah, the next track is Curb Your Ego featuring Steve fierce. He's British. And I thought he did good. Because a lot of times I don't like the way it hits my ears weird, like British rappers and the rapper. But he had a very nice flow. I enjoyed it. Matter of Time. Very political. That was featured in Nappy Music. Also produced by Nappy Music. Rock and Roll Beat. I thought that was a dope track. Talking about politics and Run Out of Time. The Earth's about to be trash out here. So that's what that's about. Available Nowhere. But first of all, I like the name of it. Available Nowhere. I thought that was an interesting meme. I think that it's a very vivid concept, this song, because he's talking about, like, he's ready for war. He's talking about, this is also my favorite beat, he's talking about some type of villain, but then he's like, he's available nowhere. I thought that was evil 1080 imaginary monster. I kept saying 1080.
I had to go back and listen to it again.
Oh, okay. He said that a few times. So, I meant to ask you about that. And he mentioned,
I've probably listened to the album, like, a good, like, maybe four times, but, yeah. Like, not enough to, like, really absorb it like I normally would.
Yeah. I thought it was an interesting track, though. I thought he really painted a villain and described him in gross detail. It's Going Down, another political track. He's basically trying to make hip-hop better. Talking about men wearing makeup, being feminized, becoming effeminate.
Yeah.
Society was screwed up. He's going to Django his way through this shit. I'm ready. He's ready. He's about to be Django right now. So.
Django!
I'm going to be on his team. Title track, FSB2, TBC, Terrifying Voice. He's saying death. yeah. Scared me. Came back going, I was like, oh, shit. He said, death is a human construct. It does not exist. That really stood out. He warned us that full spectrum dominance is here. So I wanted to say a little bit about what full spectrum dominance is and what it means. And it's basically also known as full spectrum superiority. It's a military entity's achievement of control over all dimensions of the battle space. Effectively possessing an overwhelming diversity of resources in such areas as terrestrial, aerial, maritime, subterranean, extraterrestrial, psychological, and bio or cyber technological warfare. So, that's what he's been talking about. His first and second album. So I give it a like a 7.5. Yeah, I think it was good. Beats weren't my favorite. Sometimes he sounds off beat when he raps and I don't like that. But I like what he's talking about. He's real, that's cool. So, come on in.
Cool. Appreciate it. How you like that, y'all? Okay, so FSD2 is in the same format of FSD1, and what I mean by that is still in like the blend of futuristic and like, you know, old school hip hop to me.
Yeah.
And he's kind of like blending those two sounds together. But like the beats on FSD1 sounded more like they were the beats were darker to me on FSD1. And what I mean by that, like they were more like it felt like you were really like in the apocalypse, like in the dark, trying to like find your way and survive in the world. That's how FSD1 sounded, like felt to me. FSD2 still has like those apocalyptic beats, but they're more upbeat at least. Like, you know, these guitars and things, like these instrumentals, like the way he's blending them, it's a lot more upbeat to me this time. So it's not as dark. And that and the other difference is like the features are better. Because featuring artists I think are better. I mean, but Canibus never has, I mean, his artists on his album are always, the featuring artists are always fire. Like, Canibus has never been, like, on a track on his album with, like, any whack artist, like, in his career. Like, I mean, that's Canibus for you. I could have possibly, on FSD1, took a half point off for, like, one featuring artist that was, like, a little, like, he decided to rap completely offbeat. I mean, his lyrics were still good. He was still lyrically strong, but, like, that one featuring artist, he decided, like, you know. But, and with Canibus, like, you know, Canibus doesn't, I kind of see what you're saying. He doesn't sound like, you know, especially like, not like a lot of artists that came out like in the past like 10 years. you know, that, like, are just right on beat. Like, he kind of, like, clams his words.
Yeah.
Because he's trying to say a lot.
Yeah.
But he's still on rhythm. He's not off beat at all. I mean, he's cramming out of words. And I don't know if I've said this, but he's also, like, compared to FSD 1, he's, like, dumbed down his lyrics a little bit. So those of you who are new to underground music and new to Canibus, this would be, like, a better, you know, intro for you, for, you know, one of the best underground artists.
He talks about a lot of highly intelligent.
Now, he does. Subjects. I mean, I'm just, you know, he does. I'm just saying, like, but compared to FSD 1, I don't, that FSD 1 was more, I think, I don't know, it was harder to follow. Yeah, this one's easy to follow to me. Okay. Yeah. So, but I mean, since the format is the same, I mean, there are just minor changes. I mean, I'll give you some clickbait. You know, go back to FSD 1, our first review of his first volume, FSD, to that review that we did, you know, a few schools down, as other ones you should be watching along the way.
Right.
And see what I gave that one, because I'll give this one the same rate. So go check that out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so there's some clickbait for y'all real quick. And, So, yeah, that's all I got on that. So, next we'll do, so the reason, I mean, I'll pass this for the end, but the reason I went back to Wrld On Drugs is just because I did promise in the mini review to do, like, an analysis of it.
Okay.
But it's not track by track, it's still very short, and I already said most of it. So, you want to do, Masters of the Sun next?
No, you can do that, and then I'll do Masters of the Sun again.
Okay, cool. So, yeah, so, I mean, so I was saying the same thing. I mean, I could group Wrld On Drugs and Love Me Now into, like, one review, because it's the same thing applies to both what I was saying earlier about the beats. Very few beats between both albums are good enough to overcome the trash. Love Me Now has better features. Chris Brown did his thing. Let me just kind of, like, just go through the checklist. Meat Mill didn't come through like he should have. Okay, like,
play it.
Because I mean, he sounds like all the rest of these little niggas. You know what I mean?
He's like, he's trappy.
Yeah, I mean, but he's like in the whiny singing though. Like, I mean, like that's all. I can't tell the difference between him and Tory.
Oh man,
I don't know who. I can't tell when his verse was. I would have to go on jeans to see it.
That's him.
I guess it is. I don't know. I mean, like,
are they both auto-tuned at once?
Right. The fuck, man? So, like, okay. But, you know, this album had good features. I mean, Rista Kid had a good verse. Trippy Red had a good verse. Nav had a good verse. Nav had a really high-pitched trap singing, but his verse was good. Yeah, I mean, so, you know, Trey Songz did his thing. So, I mean, better features than Wrld On Drugs.
Okay.
So, that's why I give this one a 5 and Wrld On Drugs a 4. But like I said, the beats aren't. And in fact, on both albums, really only the first beat is memorable.
Juice WRLD is young, too. He's like 19.
He's 12.
Like, yeah, he's young as shit.
Another thing the albums have in common is only the first tracks on both albums are like, you know, the beats are like, you know, bumping and memorable like that. You know what I mean? Like, okay, here's like track 1 of Love Me Now. Why Don't You Love
Thank
Me?
Thank you for turning that shit. Oh,
I know. This shit was hard on the ears, wasn't it?
You're 19 years old.
So, like, yeah, so saying they were Wrld On Drugs, like, only the first track, and then, like, the rest of the beats, like I said, all these instrumentals on both albums could just play through on their own fine until these niggas start whining. You know what I mean? And then it's like, okay, then that's where you lose your points, you know what I mean? So 4 for Wrld On Drugs, and 5 for Love Me Now for better features. But I fuck with this song, this first track, Love Me Now. You fuck with that? Yeah.
I've seen that cover too. I didn't know that's what that was for.
Yeah, and plus, Tory Lanez is talking a lot about, like, you know, love and like R&B shit on here.
He R&B singer.
He's not though. I mean, because he might be. You know what? Future kind of started this confusion. Because Future's like a singer, but he be rapping too. Like, and then not all the rappers sound like Future.
Right.
And now everybody like everyone sounds alike, y'all. Like, you know what I mean? Like, niggas was whining the whole time with Travis Scott album.
He a singer, rapper, and songwriter.
Right. I mean, Wrld On Drugs, same thing. Like, this is a bunch of whining. Like, everyone sounds alike. So it's like, the line between rapping and singing is like, what are niggas doing?
It's been fused together.
Yeah, so we can get to Masters of the Sun.
Volume 1, actually.
You're right.
Yeah, the first track is Sappiest
for y'all.
So let's see. Released October 26th. It's 58 minutes 16 seconds. It's their 7th studio album. It's not as pop and electronic as it usually is, because I've always listened to Black Eyed Peas, and this goes back to the old school hip hop ones. Good. Label Interscope, producer Will.i.am, of course. It's actually inspired by the graphic novel with the same name and similar cover art. So there's a graphic novel called Masters of the Sun by Will.i.am. If you look it up, it really looks similar to how their art looks on their cover. Fergie's not on here. The first album in, I think, 8 years with Fergie wasn't on there. There was an issue with one of the samples that they were publicly accused of, like, stealing the sample for this track named Airglow, Fires. It's a British pop star. It does sound really British poppy when you hear it. It's Constant. That's the track. It's one with Flip Ripple. So, he's featured on there. It's a dope track. I like it. So let's see. I'm just going to do a quick rundown of my tracks that I like the most. Back to Hip Hop.
Oh, yeah. Nas.
Yeah, Nas is on there. Yeah, both of their flows.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The flows are great, but Nas, like, really shines.
It's called Back to Hip Hop. Hey. So yeah, that's super dope. Get Ready, the beat is fire. That's one of my favorite beats, I believe. And it's a beat switch, so the beat I'm talking to is the beat switches
are fucking dope.
The beat switches are
through the whole album.
Yeah, yeah. Forever, another dope flow, great beat. Instruments are fantastic. They're being selected, very jazzy sounding a little bit, you know, very swanky. Dopeness. Come on. It's in the name.
Literally.
It's literally in the name. All Around the World featuring Fife Dog. Yeah, when I saw Fife Dog, I was like, oh, this is gonna be dope. And of course, he started, we on a world tour. When he started the song off. But I give this album a whole 9. I give it a 9. I think it was well put together, and it's something that I will listen to. So, the creativity is astounding.
Right.
They have good concepts. They're talking about present day things.
It's positive,
very uplifting. It's fantastic. I love it. So nice. Like, absolutely.
Yeah, positivity is always going to be a major plus.
I'm going to end with my glasses on too.
Major plus. So, like, even, I mean, Black Eyed Peas, they're good executioners. They're not, like, lyrical demons, like, you know, Tech, M, Biss, Black Thought. You know what I mean? They're not, like, you know, like, demons with the lyricism, but, you know what I mean? But they're good, solid. They got good, solid bars. You know what I mean? They're good rappers.
Yeah.
They're good. They're all good. You know what I mean? All their verses are good. You know what I mean? Good flow. You know, old school flow, which is cool, too. Beats sound traditional and contemporary at the same time.
Yeah.
Brilliant instrumentals.
Yeah.
Fucking dope beats.
I could just listen to it as an instrumental.
Right. A lot of the right. Songs, yeah. And versus some albums that we just talked about that were really better as just instrumentals. Because you need to make instrumental tracks and just stop rapping.
Don't even
talk
say
anymore.
Any just, words just on top.
Keep tape over your fucking mouth. Okay. Anyway, this is the type of album that my favorite tracks may vary. I mean, I like everything on here, so I mean, I may have a different favorite track every week. The ones I play most are the two I played: New Wave, which is on right now, and Yes or No, which is track 2. I would say those two play the most in my head. So I mean, this is. It's too many bonus points and too much genius to get this album. That's an 10 to me. It's just too much going on. It's my first time ever listening to a Black Eyed Peas album all the way through.
Oh, nice.
But I mean, I just had to. I got a call like I see it though. I mean, yeah, we're blurry right now. We're out of focus. We're I guess we gotta stop shaking the foundations. I don't know. I don't know what has to happen. Damn.
Touch it.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So we're back. But yeah, I mean, that's really all I got to say. What else you got, sis?
That's it. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. Again, Patreon, support us there. Subscribe, email us questions. We get emails all the time. We thank you guys. We love you guys. Make sure you subscribe and hit the notifications. Still doing giveaways. Amazon gift cards. Just gave one away to, what's your name? There's a girl. What's
her
name?
Shonda Eaton.
Yeah. Yep. So, thanks again. Ashley Alphas. Peace. Love y'all.